Welcome to today's session, which is about how to use Navisworks and BIM360 for clash detection and management of issues pertaining to the clashes. My name is Lois Otoi. I'm a civil engineer at Davisa Consulting. This channel is for you, and the topics we cover come directly from questions you get on a daily basis. So if you like what you see, please subscribe to the channel. We also welcome your comments on this video. If there are other topics you would like us to cover, please get in touch by leaving a comment. With that said, let's dive in. In this session, we will give you a quick overview of our model coordination workflow, leveraging Navisworks, Plan 3D, Revit, Robot Structural Analysis, Advanced Steel, and Autodesk Construction Cloud. The projects will be hosted on BIM 360 to facilitate greater collaboration between the stakeholders. So what is the purpose of coordination? We do this coordination so that we can achieve a fully coordinated model between the disciplines. That does not mean all the clashes will be resolved, others will be approved because they are just part of how the project is. And we know how we'll then be resolving those as the project progresses. The process will start with the federation of the different models, and this federated model gets tested for clashes in Navisworks. Before we commence with the clash detection, the models are taken through an internal approval process. This will verify by checking their status. The workflow will then proceed from there. Again, as we do that, we will follow these four fundamental principles of BIM management, which are to create a shared project working space, which has got a controlled access and structure. And there's also a process to track and manage the activity related to that structure. And we do this as part of managing information, because we realize that there is a very high cost when information is lost as the project progresses. So it is in the interest of the project to make sure that the information or the integrity of the information is maintained throughout the life cycle of the project. And again, this gets done through an integrated workflow that allows everybody to collaborate together on the project as it progresses. This we would do, as you will appreciate, that different types of projects involve different stakeholders. And once you start even looking at plants, like water treatment plants or manufacturing plants, they become much more complicated, and it is necessary that everybody is kept in the loop. We now want to show you the process that we follow in the case of a building project in doing the clashes and making sure that we generate all the issues. So if I just refresh that, what we've done in this case of this building is to group the clashes by levels of the building. Okay, we are able to zoom into the clash and see exactly what are the elements that are clashing. This then allows us to come up with possible solutions that can be implemented to resolve the issue. Again, you can see that this model has been put together through through federation of different models. I mean, that's the architecture, the structural model, the plumbing, mechanical, and electrical. So that's what has given rise to this federated model. So again, in here, we're able to see all these glitches. And one of the important things, again, is being able to see the issues that are then generated from these glitches, which then we are able to assign to the relevant people so that they can deal with them. So in here, this would be issue number 11, and we have assigned. Let's go to issue number 11. Yes, we have assigned somebody who must move the plumbing pipe. And again, in here, we're able to see all the activity that has been going on this issue. We are then able to share those issues from Navisworks into Docs. And when we come here, we're able to then see those issues. I think there we had looked at this one in particular, and we can see it's coming through into Autodesk Docs. This then allows the person who has been assigned this to address this issue. And once that has happened, we will then be able to retest that and see if really everything has been done. Again, I want to just show how on another type of project the same process can be done. In this project, we have a process plant where again what we've done is we have federated different models, and these came from AutoCAD drawings, which we then were able to federate into the one model, which then allows us to do clash detection in this case and generate issues as well. As you can appreciate that, especially project of this nature, there is quite a lot of clashes that can happen. So, but yes, some clashes we find that they are, it's just a base plate with holding down bolts, because here it's about a holding down bolts going into the concrete, because actually these, they fall under that. And as you can see, these are, you've got this warnings here, but it's just about them being old, but we can update them and we are back there. So let's close that group. Okay, I'm gonna come here. So in here we have got a ladder clashing with let me see that. Yeah, it's a ladder here clashing with that opening there. So these are things we need to resolve. Again, in here we might have to just move this ladder so that it falls into that opening. Again, here we are able to manage issues. And these are then shared with Autodesk Docs so that the relevant people are able to manage the project. So if we go to Docs on that project, I think it is this project. And again, we come onto the issues. We begin to see all those issues. And once these get dealt with, we will then be able to monitor that process. Again, you can open each and every one of them, and you see exactly what is it that needs to be done. I mean, here you've got this plate of this rail, the bottom rung of this rail, clashing with the concrete. So what needs to be done is to lift it out of the concrete. So the person who's this has been assigned to knows what they have to do. Again, we want to look at a different type of project. Now we have a different type of project here, where the federated model was created out of models that were made in AutoCAD Plan 3D. And the beauty of this one is that you are then even able to create such sets, which we then use in doing the clash detection, because all the various groups have been modeled separately in 3D. Again, I mean, if we zoom in there, you can actually see the pipes themselves, that these are real models and of the piping, and I think it's even a better way of doing it for more complex plans. But what we've done here, of course, you can see that the structure is still just stick diagrams, which were done in Plan 3D, and we will then from here, as we're still working on this, we will put some still sections here, which we will then export into advanced still, and we do them there, and we bring them into Revit. But that's another workflow that we can show to you on if you are interested in it. But again, the issue I wanted to show here is the fact that we are able again to do the clash detection and show situations where there are clashes, and for example, but mostly these clashes are just about a pipe going through a grating, so which is not an issue really, because what we will do on site is to create an opening there. So in most cases here, we will accept these kind of clashes, but we must put them in and show how we manage them, because here's another one there. But again, I just want to show you that the same, having created these, they are then shared with Autodesk Docs, and they are able to show there. For example, this is that project, and these are the pipe creating issues that we were seeing, and we're able to again see them on this side. So again, we are then able to, having assigned them to somebody, once they get addressed, then we can manage the whole process of how we do that. If we now come to Autodesk Docs, we're able to come to our federated model and view these issues. Because now when we click on this, again, the issue comes up, and we're able to see what is it that we need to address. And then we are able to then deal with this one. You know. So this then gives you a better way of managing your coordination and seeing what is it that hasn't been addressed yet, what is it that has been addressed, and then proceed from there. So as we can see that from this, we can zoom in on a particular clash. Having generated all these issues, we're also then able to perform reports on these issues. So if we come onto this report, we're able to then open it and see what the issues are, and then this can be shared with people in management, and they can see the status of the project and how this whole issue of the coordination is proceeding. And as the issues are getting resolved, the status will change to from open to being closed. And then we are getting closer to that status of having a fully coordinated project. And also, I think one of the beauty of this is that under Insight, we are then able to at all times see the status of our project as to what is going on, what the risks are, what are the issues that we are facing. Again, the project issues here will show. And yes, we are able to have a bit of a high level view of the issues affecting our project. The BIM coordination meetings are very important in the process of resolving the clashes, because that's where we then assign certain tasks as to who must do what in relation to the issues that has been identified on the project. So this process is very important. But again, for it to be successful, a lot of preparation has to be done upfront, which will then ensure that we have all the information we need, the issues that need to be addressed, and whatever requests for information that are there on the project can be tabled at that coordination meeting. So it is important to prepare and organize yourself. Again, we spoke about the project insights, which then are able to always keep us knowing what is happening on our project. We hope that this video has been beneficial to you, at least just to show you the workflows that you can adopt, in the hope that when you follow this kind of process, you will have an impact on your projects, and also improve the quality of the models, which then will assist the client to better manage the project when it comes to the operation and maintenance stage. With that said, thank you very much for spending your valuable time with us. Thank you very much.